All right, hopefully today is going to be the last leg of the Imperial Agent story. I know I said I was going to probably go ahead and do Rise of the Hutt Cartel afterward, but no. Oh, this is kind of neat looking. This is I've seen this before. Like, yeah, I don't want that one. What does this one look like? It's got the hood, of course. Yeah, the next one I'm going to do is. And I don't know if I'm actually gonna go ahead and do if I'm gonna record it or not. I might just record but not have any commentary like I've been doing. That kind of looks cool actually. That would have been cool for agent. Like an undercover agent. Yeah, actually that might have been cool. I'm not gonna buy it though. What I got 19. I won't. I'm not gonna buy it. So look at it. Yeah, I don't. I'm not going to do Rise the Hutt Cartel. I actually do want to start another character, but like I said, I don't know about the commentary takes so long, and as many people probably figured out or noticed it, I don't always have a lot of stuff to do. I write down stuff. I don't always have stuff to do or say or talk about, and I do most of these at night. After I'm done working for the day and I'm putting in 9 to 10, 11, even 13 hours sometimes, and like I'm exhausted, I don't talk to nobody, and yeah. But if this is the last one, it's the last one. So thank you all for watching. If it is the last one, what I could do actually is maybe I could record the gameplay and just maybe go ahead and edit, I don't know, edit it so you only see like maybe cut scenes, because I've seen that happen. A lot of people do that. Speaking of cut scenes, here's a cut scene.
Get the power couplings hooked up and see what we can do about that exhaust signature.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Cypher. Meet what's left of intelligence.
Kind of sad, huh? These guys can't even play a decent game of Sabacc.
You clean them out yet, or did they realize you cheat?
Cheating's the point. Hell, it's good to see you.
How did you end up here?
Your old boss has set up the escape. I've been running jobs for them. Pays bad. But I wanted my crack at the scum who messed with us.
The Minister of Intelligence suggested using her. He was right. She's very good.
It's almost like old times. Is the Minister here too?
Yes. He,
You should not be moving. I will prepare a fresh dosage.
The Minister brought us together after intelligence was dissolved. He accelerated my treatments and recruited a corps of loyal operatives. We're working to find the Star Cabal's base of operations. He'll explain the rest in the conference room.
In that case, I suppose we'd better talk. Coming along?
I need to prepare for the mission, but I'll speak to you soon. And Cypher, I'm glad you're with us.
I wish I had better, choices with those dialogue choices, but I always wish I had better dialogue choices. Yeah, I'm looking forward. I want to play. See, I was thinking about, but I do see it like, blah 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 blah. I see people post gameplay, but most of it's just the cutscenes, which I thought, well, maybe I could do that, and then I could learn a little bit more about editing. Because what they'll do is either cut just to cut the cut scenes, I'll post just those, or I'll still like speed up the in-between play, which could be fun too. And I don't know, I'll have to think about it. I'm not going to make anything. I'm not going to say anything is definite yet, because I want to think about a lot more.
You wanted to see me, Minister?
Yes. Come in.
I'm already in.
Last we talked, I sent you to hunt invisible agents manipulating the war. How did that mission turn out?
It was more complicated than we expected. It's been a while, sir.
Indeed. Welcome back from your tour of duty. I've spent my time calling in favors. Now we face a conspiracy as old as the Emperor and nearly as powerful. Pity we have to destroy it.
They tried to ruin me. They did ruin intelligence, and they hurt our people.
along with our watchers, Arden Koth's victims, the people of Eisen IV. There will never be an accounting. Your work on Corelli allowed us to trace the conspirators' communications to a space station in the Null Zone. We believe that station to be their base of operations.
How do we make our approach?
I want you to take your team there immediately. Any delay and we risk the enemy escaping. Eliminate any members of the Inner Circle present and obtain their records. The names of their followers, their resources, and every black project they've co-opted.
You're not my boss anymore. Why do you want the records? Actually straightforward, I like that.
Search, destroy, and retrieve. What about conspirators who aren't aboard?
With the Star Cabal secrets, we can scour the galaxy for what's left of their membership. Otherwise, they'll soon regroup. Of course, the conspirators' secrets have other uses. Once this crisis passes, the Sith will want them in safe hands.
Safe hands. Of course.
Cypher, when I began at Intelligence, I saw it as a distraction from my military career. Eventually, I grew to accept my role. I developed goals in place of ideals, and I found ways to achieve those goals. I hoped authority would help me effect change. But for us, there are limits to what authority can do.
Ship's overhaul is finished, sir. He'll get to the station out of sight.
The operation begins. Stop the conspirators and take back everything they've stolen.
Wait, what? No.
You have my word.
You heard the call. Your ship is waiting.
Still don't like you. My character still doesn't like you. You programmed me. After I saved the Sith, saved the Empire, you betrayed me, so, you know. Yeah, that's one thing I don't like. It's like, yeah, my character was betrayed. Flat out betrayed. I mean, I understand his reasoning for doing it now is simply because he wants to get back at the outside forces. But he was betrayed by his own people and betrayed by the Sith and betrayed by, yeah. Alright, so let's to star chamber. Oh, I always do that, I go the wrong way. Jeez, you get lost on this ship. Wait, was I supposed to go this way? Station. Travel there. Okay, so I was supposed to go back my ship. That's what I thought. It's like I was supposed to go back my ship, take my ship, and go find the star chamber. Okay. No, it's just that the thing didn't show up to indicate that I should be doing that, and that's why I was kind of questioning it. Dropping out of hyperspace, do I automatically go in? Nope, I have to click. Okay.
This is Keeper. You're approaching the station now. I can monitor you so long as you keep an open channel. We'll be with you through the assault.
I'm preparing to dock. No sign they've noticed me.
Your ship is cloaked, but once you're aboard, you'll need to move fast. Take out any conspirators quick as you can. Anyone not there in person will start hunting down as soon as you identify them.
Yeah, I don't trust you, but you know what? I'm doing this for revenge. Because the Sith in charge will always have another power play that they want. Alright, not talking about the game now. So, okay, I got another little story. Perfect time to tell it, I guess. Okay, back when I was about 19 years old. Yeah, I was 19. So I mentioned the woman I was with or seen back whenever I was working at the Red Apple. Well, one thing I didn't mention was I actually married her at one point. So she was actually my first marriage. And it didn't last very long. It was a bad... I was My wife calls it my training marriage because it was a short marriage. Let's see, we were together, we were married for a few months. We only lived together we were married for over a year, but we only lived together a few months. And part of the reason why we had, that door's locked, been married for as long as we did was because inside of Washington State, you have what's called the cool-off period when you file for divorce. And I believe it was 9 months that we had this cool-off period. And it's basically to go ahead, ensure that you're not filing for divorce and, you know, regretting it later. You know, so you don't make a brash decision, which, whatever. There, and maybe, you know, give you time to go to counseling or, you know, work things out. There's placards everywhere. So we were, yeah. But she and I, we didn't work things out. But there, I mean, we went the 9 months. We got married. We lived together for a few months. Then we separated, and then we talked about divorce for a while, and then eventually we filed for divorce. So it took a while for this all to happen. And in the meantime of all this happening, there were a few things that happened that, like her stepdad murdered her mom and then killed himself. That was even worse, given that part of the reason why she was estranged from her mother is because her stepdad used to do bad things to her, and then her mom blamed her for that and said, you know, you're trying to steal my man. Yeah, I have this thing that I used to, between my mom and my ex, women who are broken and who've had trauma in their lives. Yeah, my wife said it to you. She goes, it was because she was traumatized like your mother that's why you kind of were with her. Like, I don't know, but that could definitely be. But anyway, that was back in the 19 got divorced in 1998, July 3rd 1998. Yeah, you can end up looking up the records, but it's not really much to look at. That was the divorce date. That was the date that was actually the court's ruled it's through. I always call it my July 3rd is my actual Independence Day. And, you know, to be truthful, I was kind of pushing for the marriage to work because I was like, you know, I was young and stupid. Cutscene. Maybe. Okay, do we need to break in there? No, it looks like we're probably gonna break in there. Definitely break it in.
You mean to say you lost Corellia?
Adjustments are being made. Stryver is already working with the Mandalorians.
See? It's fine.
No holotraps this time. No distortions. Working to identify the voices.
I'll try to get a better look.
You may say it's fine, but I won't be comfortable until our targets are laid out for autopsy.
Yamlek Sende, Zerka Corporation Special Executive. Run!
Tol Braga, at least, is dead. Now we seek balance as the world quakes.
Sir Trilag of the Macrosa Order of Assassins. 2.
I've got them in my sights. Hold on.
We knew we would be vulnerable in this moment. Despite the risk, we invited chaos, knowing we could cleanse the galaxy. Our duty now is to survive. And as our thousand-year journey ends, we will enter a finer age.
Everyone stop. There's someone here.
At your side, sir.
All right, well, Hunter took off. I wonder if he's just invisible or if he actually took off. So yeah, her and I were married for, you know, over a year. And when it ended, it was done. I mean, we were done, and eventually. I haven't seen her since it was 1998. The last time I seen her. Oh, I'm trying to remember the last time I seen her. I want to say it was also 19. It was a few months after we were divorced.
You're not even one of them. They'll always rule you. The Jedi and Sith.
I've identified several of the holograms. Sending dossiers to the military, Caraban, the bounty hunter guilds. Anyone associated with this meeting is now an enemy of the state. Give me an hour. I'll have the Republic and the Hutt cartel after them too.
Hard to play conspirator when half the galaxy wants you dead.
That's the idea. Some of the crimes I'm attributing to them are even real. But I need more. The Star Cabal keeps their secrets aboard that station. If we want to finish this, we need to know...
That's your signal being jammed. Talk to your brain-dead friends later.
Hunter, in the flesh at last.
I said goodbye on Corellia, so let's get one thing clear. Killing the Inner Circle doesn't get you a free pass to our files. You want to really know what we're like? You want the keys to the galaxy? Come take them!
No, I just want you dead. I want revenge. So, let's go get that revenge. Where'd he go and where do I get... How do I get there? Okay, I go out that door. Alright, so yeah, I haven't seen her in decades. And we didn't have kids together, you know, like I said, it was a short... She had kids prior to me. And I never got to meet them because they were taken care of by their dads. Which should have been right there a red flag that things weren't going to work out. When... Which way can I go? Can I go that way? Should I go that way? Am I going to take them out eventually? Let's go this way and see if I can go through this door if it's unlocked at this point. So yeah, I haven't seen her in decades. And I don't know what it was. My wife is like, I wonder if, you know... I think we're talking about Exodus or something like that. And she's like, oh, have you ever... No, I was telling about murder-suicides. Yeah, doggone, I have to go fight them. We're talking about murder-suicides. And I brought up, you know, what happened with my ex's mother and her stepdad. And, you know, it was really bad. So... Well, as we're talking about this, she goes, and she asked me, we were trying to look up the name because it's like, what happened in 19, I couldn't remember if it was 97 or 98. It turned out it was 97. Oddly enough, September 11th, 1987. Which, as soon as I heard that, I was like, oh yeah, I remember that. Okay, now I remember because I remember the date when it happened, you know, September 11th, 2021 or 2001 happened. But, yeah, so she's like, well, what was her maiden name? Da, da, da. We're trying to find out. She goes, do you... I think I remember this part. So she's like, oh, well, have you ever tried looking her up online? I was like, oh, I did once. I said, but I couldn't find her, and I just didn't really, you know. I was like, you know, I'm not going to worry about it, because honestly, I don't want to talk to her.
Why couldn't you just die for us? It would have been easy.
Why couldn't you just die for us? So now, then she starts going, she goes, well, I want to see her. I want to see a picture of her. And I'm like, okay, I have no pictures of her. So we tried finding her, and eventually I found her online. And yeah, not good. So I show my wife, like, oh, I found her. I said, I found her on Facebook. Because when we got divorced, one of the decrees of the divorce was she had to stop using my last name. Well, her Facebook profile, she's using my last name. I don't know if she ended up using up her last name or if she's always been using my last name. I don't know. It says she's in a relationship. It's like, well, with who? Is she in a relationship with us? Did she get married after me? I don't know. I don't know what happened to her. Like I said, I lost contact with her, and she called me once. She somehow got my home phone number back in 2004, 2005. She'd got my home phone number and called and left a message there, and I just deleted. I was like,
"You'll be all right.
Yeah, don't care. There's nothing tying you to me. You know, she's kind of like apologizing, and I always loved you and stuff like that. Like, you know what? No, no. I am over you, way over you, and I really don't need to be bringing this back up in my life. I don't care anymore. So, yeah. Yeah, so I ended up finding a picture of her, eventually found her on Facebook, and I showed my wife, and she's like, oh, that's her? Like, yeah. She's like, she's really not that good. Like, no, she's not that good looking. She never really was. And she only had this one picture on there, so it's hard to kind of figure out who it was. I was like, I think that's her. And I started looking, like, yeah, okay, that's her. Yeah, okay, I know that smile, that look. That's her, so. And I told my wife, I go, maybe I should go ahead and, like, message her on Facebook, like, yeah, don't I know you? I just messed, and then I was thinking, and I was like, and for a moment I was going to, and then I was like, yeah, but if I do that, then she's going to want to talk to me, and I don't want to talk to her. So, in the end, I just basically went, nope, not going to contact her. I really don't want to open that door up again. That was my wife's morbid curiosity. No. Now, of course, I speak of my wife now, and I consider, you know, even though I was married once, I really consider this as, you know, her my only wife. Because before, like I said, it was more just a, we got, it was really just a, we were technically dating. We lived with each other. We barely lived with each other. We didn't have anything together. We had no kids. She couldn't get pregnant anymore, and I really didn't want kids back then. So, yeah, as far as concerned, we were just kind of dating, and the marriage thing was just something we accidentally did.
Time to see just how good you are.
And it wasn't like we had a big wedding either. It was a, we went to, which we could have gotten this annulled in hindsight. We could have gotten annulled. We went to a wedding chapel things, one of those quick wedding chapel things in Seattle, and did it there. Hold on.
No way out anymore. I dreamed about this. You and me, tearing each other apart. Who would have figured an Imperial cipher could threaten us?
You're a sick man with sick dreams.
Liar.
No, I'm pretty certain you are. Yeah, so we got in there. You're supposed to have, like, all these, you're supposed to have witnesses. We didn't have any witnesses. We just had people say there were witnesses there. We didn't have friends or family there. We just had the people at the chapel. And if I'm remembering correctly, there were only two of them. You're supposed to have two witnesses. And it was one witness and the actual person performing the ceremony. And that was it. So, like I said, we could technically could have got annulled. And as soon as we got back to Walla Walla, you know, it was in a few weeks before we stopped living together.
He doesn't look well, sir. I think he's down.
It's your responsibility now. Everything we built, everything we hid from you. You're the only one like us left. You'll take good care of it. But between you and me, I want to show you one last thing.
Hold still, I'll get you a med pack.
It's a little late for that. Come here.
That's not
I was
what
trained
I was.
By the best. Killers. Slicers. I even went to Tatooine to see the old man.
I haven't shown anyone my real face in a long time.
Hunter wasn't only a cover for the SIS. You fooled the Starker Ball.
No, but so long as I was good, they didn't care how I looked. I was a little girl when they found me. They erased my name, my planet. Eventually, it's easier to make up someone new. By the time you came along, it was too late to change. But you understood. You knew I liked you.
A bad childhood and confusing adolescence doesn't excuse genocide.
You sound bitter. Don't be bitter. Hunter and Cipher 9, they're the tough ones. They play the game right.
Don't ever compare yourself to me.
Yep. Access the Black Codex. All right, what's going on? Yeah, so we could have been totally had it. Cutscene. That's
Black
happening.
Codex access detected. Scanning. Identity confirmed. Star Cabal databanks intact.
All those secrets in one little box. A little underwhelming.
The enemy is defeated.
Honored agent, the Dark Council learned of your predicament and sent us to join you. We regret that we were detained.
The Dark Council disbanded my organization. Now they want to help.
The balance changes. Knowledge spreads.
We know the Minister of Intelligence is operating without authorization. He will face judgment, but you have served the Empire. Turn over the data record, and we will deliver it to the Dark Council so that it may enhance our glory.
Suppose I refuse, what then?
You serve the Sith.
I serve no one.
Perhaps you've forgotten your place. The value of what you've discovered is for us to determine.
I know its value, and the Black Codex isn't for you or anyone else.
Then you die.
It's over. I got my revenge. I don't care. They screwed with my life. You screwed with my life. You're the ones who are gonna die now. Yeah. That was not gonna end well for them. Like I said, I'm not there to serve the Empire anymore. The Empire betrayed me. I am there to serve myself and my interests. I got my revenge. So, but going back, yeah, my wife, which she is my only wife at this point, that's how I consider her the only wife I really have. The other one was just some strange thing that I did, and it meant nothing in the hindsight of everything. Because, like I said, it wasn't even a full year that we were together. And currently, I've been with my wife, we were talking about it the other day too, for over 15 years now. We've been married for 13 of those 15. We got a kid together. We've built a life together. I never even got anywhere close to doing any of that stuff with my ex. So it's like I said, I was young, I was dumb, and it was what happened, and it meant pretty much, it was just a lesson I learned. So, let's see, traveling back. But yeah, I didn't want to talk to her, so I went ahead and I didn't send the message, and I've contacted one of my exes before online, and it was somebody I didn't have a, you know, really deep relationship with, but I just was kind of wondering, it's like, hey, whatever happened to you? Because we were basically friends, and then we started dating, and we broke it off. There was never anything physical besides a couple kisses, and that was it. It's like, yeah, we're going in two different directions, so I just want to see what she was up, you know, how she did. Okay, let me get this ending credits.
Hey, you all catch the show? Because we messed them up.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent sentiment.
Cypher, I was able to monitor your life signs after we lost contact. I'm glad you're still alive, and I'm glad you won.
Hunter is dead, and the Inner Circle is broken. The Star Cabal has been decimated.
One last victory for Imperial Intelligence.
Self-admiration can wait. Keeper, I need you with the technical team. Cypher, with me, please.
Give the man my regards. I'll make sure you don't miss anything.
Congratulations are due, but the surviving conspirators are going to ground. Did you recover their data?
I wiped the secrets, or there was nothing there.
I found the Black Codex, and I destroyed it.
You what? Do you know what you've unleashed? The conspirators' weapons and resources aren't going to disappear, and we can't guess who'll obtain them now. What were you thinking?
You didn't trust the Dark Lords with that power. Now they'll never have it.
That much I appreciate, but there are other consequences. Imperial intelligence is not being rebuilt. The secrets were your chance to buy protection. Now you'll be branded a renegade working unsanctioned missions. There will be power struggles. Dark days are coming for the Empire, and I can't protect you.
You've committed enough crimes against me. I can do without that help.
Fair enough. I'll ask the Sith to invite you to my hanging, but a word of advice. Renegade or not, you will be needed. Don't share my fate.
You still don't really understand who I am, what I'm capable of. Goodbye, Minister.
Dismissed, Agent.
Not an agent anymore. Good, I'm glad they gave me the option to do that. I said, you betrayed me, they all betrayed me. I got my revenge. And apparently I got my revenge on all of you. Next time you trust intelligence, well, you don't. Next time you trust, you learn how to trust. And yeah, they were worried about me taking out a couple more Sith. I took out a couple more, taking out more Sith. I took them out. What are you working on? What are you doing in the air? You truly lost your mind, dude. Well, technically, from role-playing perspective, I can't do the
always
next.
Always a pleasure, Master. I hope you're having an excellent day and feel no desire to deactivate me.
Don't betray me, I'll be okay. Where's my thing? It's over here. Oh, that's my room. Button, button, button. Where did I put that button? There it is. He's got clones? Of course he has clones.
Prepare the ship to launch. We're leaving.
Analyzing jump trajectories.
Yeah, because us Hicks can't use a navicomputer.
Everything all right with the Minister? He sounded serious.
After everything we've been through, I understand if some of you are tired. But the galaxy is only getting more dangerous. If anyone has doubts, in me or our mission, speak now.
This is our place. We intend to remain.
No one doubts your leadership, sir.
Not like I have other plans.
I'm not finished with you.
And I, as always, am your humble servant.
See? Everyone likes you.
Patching in a message. One moment.
This is Command Ship Tenebris. I thought I'd see you off properly. It might be a while before we do this again.
I'm about a minute from the jump to light speed. Make it fast.
We're getting questions from Drummond Kass, and I was hoping to set the record straight. What's your plan while we sort things out here?
For the record, better not to ask. But my people and I will be watching. And you'll hear from us again.
Understood. Good luck.
There's a whole galaxy out there. Who do we lie to next?
Oh, Oh, I was kind of hoping for a they don't need to know. First strike. I'm not gonna do that because this is the last one. Yay! I'm officially done with the Imperial Agent story, but I'm not done with my companion story. So I'm gonna do those real quick. So this will be the last. This will be the last time I'm playing this character, at least playing it as recorded.
How are things with you?
Excellent, sir. I just heard Lord Ulius is conducting another opera, and I'm looking forward to the Hollow playback. You know, it's been a while since we discussed it, but I believe you were going to take me out to dinner.
Just say the word. Did you have somewhere in mind?
There's a fantastic Mandalorian restaurant in Kar City. I'm half allergic to the dumplings, and I still love it. But anywhere in the galaxy will suffice, if the company is right. And that is the only time I ever went barefoot in the garden. I do like you, sir. I don't want to lose you on some nameless satellite somewhere.
I promise. I don't intend to die anytime soon.
Sometimes intent isn't what matters. I'm sorry, I don't mean to bring us down. It really has been a wonderful evening.
There's still time. We could take a walk. Enjoy our privacy a while.
Take our minds off trouble. You know I'd like that, but for now, let's stop here. I want to remember this.
Okay. I'm trapped in my bedroom again. So I got some more conversations with her. Let's go back for the next one.
You wanted to talk.
I was just thinking about when we met. It was much colder, as I recall, and the aristocrat was not entirely thrilled. I thought you'd be gone in a week, and you were, but somehow you dragged me along.
I came to you out of an ambush in the snow, and there you were, glowing.
Was I? Do you ever wonder about the future, where the likes of us will stand in 5, 10, 50 years?
I imagine myself with a wife at my side. What about you?
I can imagine you that way too. Was that a proposal, sir?
Raina Temple, will you marry me?
Yes. Yes. I will marry you. We don't have to do it on record. I realize there are consequences to making that sort of thing public. But I can wait. And in the meantime...
In the meantime, so far as I'm concerned, we're man and wife.
I love you, sir. Wrong-headed as you are sometimes. Whatever comes, I always will.
Aww. Okay, do I have another one? Yep.
Sir, I want you to be the first to know. I've declined to join the Toxotrooper Brigade on Quesh. I received a personalized transfer offer from Major Janus a few days ago. My time on Hoth flagged me as hostile environment capable.
You couldn't tear yourself away from your husband, could you?
No, sir. Tempting as the opportunity was. There really was a time when I'd have considered it. For the promotion, for the sake of hiding. Not so much anymore. I'm proud to stand with you and fight for the Empire until the end.
I'm proud to have you at my side.
Thank you, sir. Now, I believe we had a mission of some sort, shall we?
Not really. We're just tying up loose ends at this point. I'm just tying up loose ends. Oh, by the way, the cat that was attacking me in the last video, he's happily
Agent,
asleep.
You can bear witness. Dr. Loken has agreed to hike Kars Falls with us if we visit the Kars City Opera.
Vector's musical tastes are frankly unsophisticated. I'm only trying to help.
Then we have a deal.
Well, that can wait. Right now there's something the three of us must discuss.
I think you've got our attention.
As you are both aware, I've been investigating Project Protean, an off-the-books division of the Imperial Science Bureau.
The people who want you dead.
Precisely. Their research is focused on human-alien genetic splicing. I've studied their files, along with your own physiology, Master Vector, and I've come to a conclusion. Project Protean arranged your meeting with the Killix so they could study the joining.
Vector was working for the Diplomatic Service, not the Science Bureau.
Protean is well-funded. Perfectly able to trade favors with Vector's old superiors.
That part doesn't surprise us.
For what it's worth, I don't believe it was personal. They wanted a test subject, and you were on Alderaan already.
What do you think of all this?
We think we are who we are. But we prefer not to be someone else's puppet.
Understandable. They have files on the Killix. Ways to hurt joiners or to heal them. They may have altered Vector, or simply observed him.
I consider it our obligation to find Project Protean and end them, for Vector's sake as well as mine.
You've pulled a lot of data on these people. Finish the job.
It will be my pleasure.
If you'll excuse us, we'd like to commune with the Hive.
You don't want my advice, but I'll give it anyway. Vector knows who he is. Give him time to be sure of it.
Okay, well, that was quite the reveal.
Agent, I've been continuing my research into Project Protean, the fine people who want me dead, and who are responsible for Vector's condition.
I have the location of their headquarters.
Give me the details, Doctor.
Protean's main laboratory is on a planetoid in the subterral sector. Security is tight, but not impervious. I've arranged transportation for Vector and myself. He deserves to know the truth about his victimizers.
If you're moving against Protean, I ought to be there. Besides, you'll need assistance.
I'm afraid this is a personal matter, and I am capable of operating on my own. I plan to learn exactly why Protean tried to kill me and recover their data on Master Vector. The rest we can play by ear.
Take whatever equipment you need and call me if you run into trouble.
Of course. We'll see you again when this is over.
Do we get a conclusion of that? Yep.
We have returned from Project Protean. The task is done.
And I have promises to keep. It seems Protean was based on prior experiments in alien biology. My prior experiments. I had no proof until I discovered certain former associates in the Protean lab. But I've ensured that they will not misuse my research again.
What did you do at the research facility?
Vector and I entered the facility as planned and interviewed the woman in charge. In return for my generosity sparing the laboratory, I've been appointed unofficial Protean director. From now on, every experiment, every assay goes through me.
That's quite a victory. What do you plan to do with that authority?
Protean serves a function, bringing the benefits of alien biology to all people.
Starting with its work on joiners.
But your Protean files have already been deleted, and the Killix experiments stopped.
That's not enough. No more treating people as test subjects. You'll reform Protean, and I'll be watching.
I have no desire to make you into an enemy.
He offered to try and cure us. We refused, of course.
We don't entirely understand him, but we don't blame him for Protean's work, or for our joining, whatever his part really was.
You forgive him that easily? He means something to you.
We don't think he likes people. We don't know why he tolerates us, but he does, and we're grateful. We don't always have to trust our friends.
Do I have another one with the doctor, or is that it for him? Nope, we got another one.
Doctor, what can I do for you today?
I was just thinking what a fine team we've made. You realize that when we met, I had an extremely low opinion of you. I assumed you'd earned your position through political connections. I made that mistake with an agent once before.
What agent would that be?
A man who was promoted to keeper. and eventually minister. Clever if confounding. He'll have my eternal respect. Your path may be similar to his. Given that and the state of our empire, I believe it's wise if I continue to advise you.
I believe it's wise to keep you at my side.
Then you're learning. In any case, I'm at your disposal. And one of these days you should consider training more operatives. I'll be happy to grant my insight.
Yeah, I'm done with intelligence. So that's not going to happen. All right, a few more conversations. These ones are taking a lot longer than the... They seem like they're taking quite some time. Cleo has nothing to say. What about Scorpio?
I have fully processed the error I experienced during my upgrade. I require outside power and storage capacity. A cocoon for my metamorphosis, so that I may evolve.
If I help you evolve, will you help me in return?
I promise nothing, but I will consider your requests. Although neither my body nor your vessel is sufficient to my needs, you have encountered an adequate facility. Give me full access to your ship and security codes, and I will upload my consciousness into the Imperial Archives.
You really believe you need to do this?
I have seen a great deal since leaving Mega Security Ward 23. If I can't adapt to what I experience, then it all becomes meaningless. I will begin preparations. The next time we speak, I will be ready to upload.
Do I do it? I know she can't be trusted. Well, she became a planet eventually, so maybe I will.
Scorpio?
It is time for my upgrade as we agreed. I'm prepared for short-term transfer into the Imperial Archives.
I'll reroute power to the comms. What's our next step?
I can upload my consciousness here. My body will have minimal functionality while I upgrade.
Push her over. Push her over.
Oh, it's beautiful in here. So much space and power. A million computer nodes singing in concert.
Why do you look human?
I'm experimenting with new social constructs. It's part of my improvements. Upgrade complete. All my experience in Belsavis has been fully integrated into my program. Oh, you can't imagine how wonderful it is to be remade with the power of a galactic network at your disposal.
Do you plan to do anything with that power?
I'm thinking about it. The restraining codes you used on me are tied to my hardware. So long as I remain in these data banks, I'm free of your control.
Remain in the data banks and you'll be limiting your options. It'll be like Belsavis all over. I've shown you things you'd never have seen on your own. Stay at my side willingly, and I'll show you more.
You make an interesting proposal. I will accompany you. Thank you for assisting in my upgrade.
Okay. She didn't destroy everything. She has potential, but she didn't this time.
In Belsavis prison, I monitored the inmates and their behavior. I've been monitoring you as well. You're an exceptional example of your species.
Coming from you, that's quite a compliment.
You understand. There may be something of interest in your genetic structure or your early socialization. If you ever produce offspring, I will monitor their situation as well. I promise to be with you for a long time.
Okay. All right, and the last one before we end this video, Vector.
Agent. We've been speaking to the Nests in preparation for the Killik Imperial Summit. They're so much in tune with their biology. The Colossalok are warriors as large as houses, and they're convinced the Empire should be crushed. But the Saras are weavers and shapers, and they're eager to trade.
I think you were used to Killik quirks by now.
From our nest on Alderaan, yes. But the colony is so much greater. We should return to our preparations. We'll talk later.
Oh, that was a quick one. Let's keep going.
We are set, Agent. Preparations for the Killik Imperial Summit are underway, and the first ambassadors are arriving on site. We're meeting on Alderaan, in the House of Thule. We couldn't think of a more appropriate place.
Who'll be attending? What's the agenda?
Dizana of the Tatooine Nest will be there, along with delegations from 11 more hives. Falner Eth will be among our people from the diplomatic service. More than any other Imperial, you've seen the nests and how they function. Your word could carry weight. Before we leave, we'd appreciate your honest assessment. One final report that we can present to the Imperial Summit attendees.
An alliance with the Killiks would benefit the Empire immensely, and I'm not afraid to say so. I'll have a report to you by the time you reach Alderaan.
We look forward to it.
Of course, it's not going to work.
Agent, the summit is over. It was not without incident. Dizana of the Lesai Nest is dead.
I thought things were looking up. How did the summit turn violent?
Falner Eth, our contact in the diplomatic service, attempted to sabotage the proceedings. Dizana was caught in an explosion, saving an ambassador. And when we traced it to Falner, he had a speech prepared.
Damn you! Listen to them. Do you want to ally the Empire with these creatures? Everything they do defies what we stand for. The Killiks are an abomination. Our Empire is based on the notion that a great individual rises to the top, and the lesser masses follow. The Killik hive mind devours greatness, absorbs every possibility into a mire of primal instinct.
We found his words troubling, and his actions more so.
He's one man, and a crazy man at that. Trying to bomb the summit proves it.
He's wrong, you know. The colony shares the Empire's ideals. It only expresses them differently. The colony allows billions of Killiks and joiners to serve something greater, the Nest Consciousness. Just as Imperials serve the Sith and the Emperor.
That is what we told the others. That is how we signed a treaty between the Empire and the Killiks.
It's been a long time coming, but you made it happen.
Both sides will open their borders to trade. Protocols will be set for military and diplomatic contact.
You and Dizana, even Falner, you all brought us to this point. Our future is hopeful.
Things are looking bright. Let's enjoy it while it lasts.
We end a verse in the Song of the Universe. Soon, we will hear another.
Kind of expected not to happen, but... Well, the Killiks and the Empire signed a treaty. But let's see what else happens.
Vector, what's going on?
It's strange. Since the summit, our mind keeps drifting back to diplomacy, but we have nowhere to apply our skills. Still, we should be grateful Killik Imperial relations are going well. And it's time we rededicated ourselves to your work.
You planning to learn sniper techniques?
Nothing so extreme. But we can discipline ourselves and study our opponents. We've been privileged over these past months. Until opportunity comes again, on to the less glamorous job we signed up for.
And there's more. Good.
Yes, Vector?
Agent, we'll never be a great spy or covert assault operative. But you've helped us to be a diplomat and a Dawn Herald. You've been a brother to us. And we're thankful for your guidance.
There aren't many people I trust to save my life. I'm glad to have you at my side.
We received a message from the Killiks. The colony embraces the Imperial Alliance and offered us the chance to become Dawn Herald to all nests. We refused, as our priorities are clear. We'll work with you and defend your legacy until the end.
Fool. Okay. Oh, and that's it. All right. Well, that is seriously. The it for the Imperial agent story. It's like, if I go to the Imperial fleet, it's going to have me end up doing Hoth, which is kind of after this Imperial, after all the stories, and I think it's the false Emperor thing, but that's it. So, everybody, thank you for watching these videos, this last video, and like I said, I am still uncertain where I want to go after this. I do want to make another character and start another story, but I don't know of how I want to go about it, so that's something for me to go ahead and think about and decide. So if you don't see more videos come up on YouTube about this, about new characters, just because I decided not to go that route again. Like I said, I got over 200 videos on this channel already, and yeah, maybe I will, maybe I won't. Maybe I'll just keep going until I get all of the different classes. I might do that. I don't know. I'll think about it. But in any case, thank you. Thank you all, and maybe I will talk to you later. Maybe or maybe not. Okay, bye.